Broncos not on the ground, man, the leader. Whole gang in the field, we don't do bleachers. Pockets splitters, don't think I'm ready. You got that swag, you got that salt, then sell it. Free money, cash them out, we bailing. Saw my teacher, I was the same student fella. Now I got a lawyer, straight cash, no settlement. I'm out my element, out my element. My the same, don't need no clout, no fame.
No clout, no clout.
Bought the game, all brand new chain.
Ice,
swerve the lane, call the group the gang.
Gang, gang.
Whip that thing,
whip it.
This shit give me, ooh, yeah. Them boys fool you, trying to do it, bring the
time do.
Don't want no, they pull up with that.
No.
It's times three, this how it go. Park $1 million at the
screw.
We gon' make gon' eat that until we go.
Eat it up, eat it up.
Rich straight to the top floor.
Top.
More PJs than
PJs.
Rich like water, go to Cabo.
Splash.
Cash in the walls, hollow.
Cash.
Your money too small, micro. Huncho on the call, got a. She don't ski,
splash.
Think about folks not on the ground, man, delete
her. Delete it.
Whole gang in the field, we don't do bleachers.
Gang.
Think about folks not on the ground, man, delete her.
Delete it.
Whole gang in the field, we don't do bleachers.
Yeah. Ice the gang,
ice.
Had to ice the gang.
Ice.
So much ice,
too much,
had to ice the lane.
Whew.
Freeze the dub,
freeze.
Had to freeze the lane.
Freeze,
camera phone.
All right, Coach, it's the NFL on EA Sports as you take a look there at Lincoln Financial Field in Philadelphia, PA. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that was in evidence a moment ago. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it, this crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up between the Chicago Bears and the Philadelphia Eagles. This fielded at the two. And he'll take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line.
Come on now, all right. Come on now. Let's go. Let's go, let's go. Great, great.
On first and 10, here's Wentz. And the catch made. This is Emmanuel Sanders. And he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here. A gain of 6 there on first. I think defensively you're okay with that. You're in the first quarter. He's going to get some catches, but they rallied to him quickly.
And that's what you count on. And I like what you just said. First quarter, can you do it all game long? They catch it, you tackle them, they go down on the spot. Because when you're able to do that and you don't give up big chunks of yardage after the catch, now you put the offense in a position where every series they have to work hard to pick up first downs, and you tend to stall them out when you do that.
They try to throw on second down, but this one is incomplete.
I think he had to unload that one before he wanted to. He was right up in his grill. I think he was a dentist there without a license, don't you?
Just not enough time for the play to develop. Just lucky it wasn't a fumble, really. And they'll look to avoid an early three and out here on third and four. Wentz going to throw. And this is Ertz with it, right side. And he's got the first down yardage before he's brought down at the 42. An Eagle first down, Wentz to Ertz.
And that one was a lot of fun right there because that was the game within the game. Third and short, blitz was on. What's the key for the quarterback? Get out of your hands in a hurry. And that was a quick little completion. Got the job done for a first down.
Now it's the Boise State alum, Jay Ajayi. And he stopped immediately there. No gain on the play there. Second down.
All right, quick observation, Brandon, because early on in this game, I'm seeing linebackers playing with their noses close to the line of scrimmage.
And my guess is the wheels are turning on that other sideline. As a play caller, you're filing that away right now, aren't you?
Yeah, you're trying to find that opportunity later on when you can play action them or stick something to them between the second and the third level.
They run with a giant. Oh, now he bowls him over. And 3 yards there takes him to the 45.
Sometimes your philosophies get challenged at times you don't want them to. They did try to stick to the running game on the first two plays. Didn't amount to much.
And now facing a third and long at the outset of this drive. Now Wentz on third down. Toward the sideline. Did he keep the feet in? Yes, he got them both down, says the side judge. And that's good enough for a first down. An Eagle first down. Wentz hooking up with Jeffrey. So into Bear territory now. This is first and 10 at the 45-yard line. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's going to be stopped at about the 37. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a second and 3.
Despite the blitz, they're still able to pick up a nice solid gain. The disadvantage of blitzing often alters the normal spacing and run fits and leaves creases like they were able to exploit right there.
They fake the give. Now Wentz. Sanders has it over the middle. And he's going to get this down near the 20-yard line. 17 yards on the pickup there. The drive will continue. It's a first down. They'll run it now out of the gun. And able to push his way forward here for a good little gain. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
And that's one of the reasons you like to blitz even on rundowns. It confuses the blocking assignments. It doesn't allow those offensive linemen to get up to the second level.
Wentz to throw on second down. And that one got tipped, kind of threw everything off. It brings up third.
Well, we're not playing 3 yards in a cloud of dust football anymore. I kind of get why those old school coaches sometimes didn't want to throw the football. Because if it's popped up in the air, it almost turns into slow motion. And both sides trying to get to the football, and you're holding your breath wondering whether it's going to go good or bad for your team.
It's been a pretty long opening drive. This will be play number 11 coming up on third down. Play clock down to 2 and we get a signal and a timeout. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. It's been a pretty long opening drive. This will be play number 11 coming up on third down. Throwing now is Wentz. And this is caught. Touchdown, Philadelphia. Dallas Goedert, a 16-yard touchdown. And the Eagles drive right down the field and score on the opening drive. Elliott good on the extra point, and that makes the score 7-0. Elliott now to kick this one away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Carry for the Utah man now. It's Joe Williams. And he'll fight forward to about the 27-yard line. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
They'd love to just strike back with a touchdown right here. And if it's a long play, so be it. But the main goal, get a couple of first downs. Run some plays, run some clock. Allow their defense to get a chance to catch their breath, settle down, and relax a little bit after they just gave up a score.
They'll break the huddle, come up on second and 8 at the 27-yard line. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll take this up near the 35, maybe the 34. Good work to pick up 7 yards there. That gets him into a 3rd-and-1 situation. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. And on 3rd down, a nickel formation here defensively. Try to run for it. Here's Williams. And he will have a 1st down here at about the 40. It's a pickup of 6 and good enough to move the chains.
Plenty of things to talk about here, partner, but to me, their defense gave up a touchdown on the first drive. How about how they're responding, coming back? That's a big 3rd down pickup to keep their drive alive.
On 1st down, it's Love. Dancing to his left. And he'll be taken down at the 46-yard line. The improv on the scramble there gets him 6, and it'll be 2nd down.
Now, that was not a bad scramble there on 1st down. He didn't force it, nor did he throw it away. He was able to take off, and now he made it a very manageable 2nd and short.
Try the air now with Locke. He's going to rifle one deep left. Oh, a ball batted in the air, and now it's intercepted. Picked off by Rodney McLeod. And they have the football and will take over at the 24-yard line. The Eagles offense now, they head back on the field. Now they'll be looking to duplicate the efforts of drive number one that resulted in 7 points in the 7-zip lead.
Well, you know how much I enjoy horse racing, right? Looks like they caught a flyer out of the gate, as they would say when you're running the big-time races. It means they get out to a fast start. They're setting the pace, making the other team chase now.
Now the first play of the drive there is incomplete. From the 24, they'll go again on second and 10.
Get over there. Go.
They'll run it now out of the gun. Takes it to the 26, just a 1 yard gain.
One thing to keep in mind, partner, especially in the second half, when you've got a running back of this size, of these dimensions, I can just tell you, attrition does set in for a defense, because you're excited about hitting him in the first half, maybe not so much in the second half, and some of these shorter gains turn into bigger runs later.
The Eagles on third down. A perfect 3-for-3 as they look to keep that streak going. This is 3rd and 9. Now Wentz. They set up the screen to Ajayi. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line.
Let's give a little credit there. The offensive play caller sensed that the screen pass was available. Whenever you're getting a lot of heavy pressure towards your quarterback, that's when you're thinking about running the screen and using that pressure against the defense. And it worked very well there for a first down.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll be brought down, losing yardage back at the 40. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
And the big fella stuffed that one up in a big way. I think doubling him has to be a priority, because you can't move up to the next level if you don't take care of him first.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. They'll lose a yard, and it brings up third.
I know the scouting report on him is that he doesn't possess the eye discipline to be an elite linebacker. And what that means is his ability to read, react, and make a play. But on that one, he looked like one of those guys.
The last two plays each lose a yard. They'll try to move forward here on 3rd and 12. Wentz now to throw. And Jeffrey's got it. And he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. A really good.
They saw the blitz, made the appropriate calls, got the line engaged, because now they know there are going to be extra guys coming at the quarterback, so they got their assignments down pat and kept them away from him, and he's able to step up in the pocket and fire one now for a really good strike.
Now it's Ajayi, and an alley to run, and able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down, but a nice little game. 9 yards is the pick up there, and they'll have a 2nd and 1.
Hey, when you get good yardage like that on first down, it really does a whole lot of good for your entire offense. But I love the way he's finishing those runs. At the end of things, he's making sure he gets just a little bit extra.
Stepping up, he'll try and run. Wentz can pull it down when he needs to, and the 6'5 quarterback picks up the first down. So the youngster able to use the legs to pick up the first.
And one of my pet peeves when they see this guy play, when Carson Wentz takes off running the football, I always hear people go, oh, he's sneaky athletic. No, he's athletic. Watch him do it. He's an integral part of the quarterback run game, and he gets it done very, very well.
You don't like sneaky athletic, do you?
That's just not
kind of a jab in the back.
Yeah, not when it doesn't apply. I think that's a stereotype that needs to be broken down for him.
And he'll take it into the end zone for an Eagles touchdown. Jay Ajayi, a 10-yard touchdown run. And the Eagles add 6 to their lead.
I know the play ends up in the end zone with one person carrying the ball, but how about that big mass of humanity that guided him to that spot?
Yeah, they got there, but I love the dive. Always a fan of the dive. Elliott good with a PAT, and it's now 14 to nothing. Elliott now to kick this one away. This will be taken in at the one. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. The Bears offense now getting ready to take over. Already down two touchdowns here in the first half. This becomes a pretty important drive, doesn't it?
It certainly does, and a lot of the teams script plays. We know that, right? They have a script to start the ball game, and typically those scripts go between 12 and 24, 25 plays. Down two touchdowns early, probably not very deep into their script. I think that they'll stay with it. I don't think they'll abandon it just yet and try and generate some offense on this drive.
Anything. At least 3 points, get that zero off the board. They start the drive on the ground. It's Williams. Not much room here as he only gets it to about the 30. Credit him with a one-yard gain there to make it second and nine.
Well, it's time for them to be good teammates right here. And what I mean by that is possess the ball for a little while. Get at least two first downs. Give their defense a chance to settle down a little bit after they give up a touchdown. Go,
go. On second down, here's Long. He's going to flip that out to the flat. It's complete. And he takes this up to the 40-yard line before being corralled. A nice pick up there, 10 yards, and it'll move the sticks.
And a nice gain and a broken tackle along the way, and really we shouldn't be surprised, should we? That's what runners do, especially the best ones. They break tackles and gain extra yardage.
Luck on first down. Throw left side complete. It's White. And he'll be taken down at the 46-yard line. 7 yards to pick up on the pitch and catch. On second down, Williams. And he will make his way back to where he started from, and that's all, as we will make our way to the two-minute warning. 2 minutes remain here in the first half. We'll come back to Philadelphia after this. He didn't even try to signal for a timeout, so they must have not been aware of the numbers.
I think he lost track of the time left in the play clock and probably was trying to read the defense and trying to figure out which play to run and just lost track, and it cost him.
And the delay of game penalty makes this much more difficult. 3rd and 8. Out of the gun, Luck. Flushed out right. Now he's going to throw it back deep over the middle. And at the 7-yard line, the catch is made. And he takes this one in for a Bears touchdown. Allen Robinson, 58 yards. And the Bears draw a bit closer. And that one makes it 14-7. Gold now out to kick it away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. The Eagles coming out as they get ready. And right now they're saying, hey, let's keep this going. Two drives, two touchdowns.
Yeah, can't ask for a better start than that, can you? I mean, this is the way you practice it. This is the way you rehearse it. But right now, the play calling, they're locked in really well.
Now a play fake here on first down. And it's incomplete. Boy, he doesn't drop many like that one. Second down.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away. But the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
Line of scrimmage, again the 25, second and 10. Here's Ajayi. And he'll get this one up to the 26. It was the linebacker Leonard Floyd on the stop.
Well, that's a good start to this drive on the defensive side of the ball.
You know, force the incompletion on first down. Then you're able to shut down the running play on second.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised now. A little bit of pressure going at the quarterback in the expected passing situation.
To throw, it's Wentz. Trying for the tight end, Ertz, and it's intercepted. Picked off around the 41. And a return will stop right around the 25.
Well, that's a drive killer right there. Not a really confident throw either. This one was kind of up for grabs, and it's going to come down the hands of the wrong team.
Down carry, it's Williams down to the 25, and the Eagles are going to go ahead and take another timeout. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. Forward here for a modest gain. And now we're going to get a timeout here called by the defense, as they'll stop it with exactly a minute to go before halftime. Well, they were handed great starting field position on this drive, but now they face a third and four. Here's Luck. The screen pass here to Cohen. And he is in. Touchdown, Chicago. A great play there from 19 yards away. And the Bears are an extra point away from tying the football game. Gold with the extra point. And we've got a tie game here in a back and forth first half. So a tie ball game here as the kick's away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. The Eagles offense now gets set to head back onto the field. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious, because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here. They're throwing to start the drive, but that one incomplete.
They kind of forced that one there, didn't he? It's almost like he predetermined where he was going to go with the football.
Yeah, he wasn't really going through progressions. He wanted to go to his top guy. You do that against this defense, they'll make you pay, won't they?
Yeah, they certainly will. They react very quickly to the thrown football.
Line of scrimmage, again the 25, second and 10. Now Wentz on the bootleg, rolling to his left. Jeffrey with a catch, left side. And they work this well upfield across the 45. And a nice gain of 21 yards.
On any given pass play, you never know exactly where your exit points are going to be. On this play, it was flushed to his left, still on the run, able to accurately throw the football for a nice first down.
And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
Even without a ton of pressure in his face, it just shows how difficult it is to pick apart his own defense. Those guys are sitting back, and they're not playing receivers as much as they're playing the eyes of the quarterback and when he delivers the ball.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Again, it's Wentz. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Bryce Callahan. That late in the clock, second quarter, why not just run it a time or two and get it into the locker room?
What you're saying makes absolutely perfect sense. Run it and get out of there. But I'm just wondering if the pressure of today's NFL and the high-powered offenses that you're facing may have forced them into saying, let's try and get some more points.
They've got good starting field position as they come up here first and 10. After the interception, it's Love, eluding the pressure right. Give him a couple on the scramble, it's second down. Throw on second down is Love. He's going to sling this deep downfield. And that'll be incomplete with just 6 seconds left on the clock. He was trying to hit Taylor Gabriel that time. And it's third down. The Bears on third down. A perfect 3-for-3 as they look to keep that streak going. This is third and 8. A shotgun snap for Love. And that's caught inside the 35. So we've reached halftime here on opening weekend. As we'll get you down the coast to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman at REA Sports Halftime Report. Coach! We'll see if week one fatigue becomes any kind of a factor as we are back underway in the second half. This is taken at the 3. And he'll get it up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. So here's the Bears offense now as they get set to start this third quarter. First half showed us some pretty good offense. Tie game, we'll see what the second half brings.
And it'll be interesting because I think both sides feel pretty good about what their offenses are doing. Gotta wonder what adjustments are being made defensively to try and get a spark and maybe slow down the other side.
But here, do you change up anything on this opening drive?
Not offensively, you don't.
He's got daylight. He's at the 40, the 20. And he is taken down deep in Philadelphia territory. It's a big-time play there for the Bears. 61 yards that time on the ground. A real field flipper there as all of a sudden they've got a first down in the red zone. They'll run it now out of the gun. And able to push his way forward here for a good little game. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and 5.
And that's exactly what you want on a first down run. Pick up 5 yards, bring up second and 5. The defensive line, though, they've got to figure out a way to out-leverage the guys up front because the offensive line is winning at the point of attack.
They try again with Cohen. And he'll be taken down at the 2-yard line. It's a 10-yard gain there, and it sets him up now first and goal.
Would you say this offense is locked in right now?
They're having no trouble on this drive. What is it, 3 plays, 3 first downs?
Yeah, you talk about on the march. They keep this up, they'll get to that end zone real fast.
So So three plays already first and goal, and they are wasting little time. They'll run it with Williams. And he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Chicago. A great effort there, taking it in from 2 yards out, and the Bears have broken the tie. And this is no good. It's a missed extra point. Boy, in a tight game, how important might that turn out to be here as the second half rolls along? Gold now out to kick it away. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. So here are the Eagles now as they get set for their first possession of the second half. They're down in this game. A chance for the offense, though, to put something on the board, get some momentum here in half two.
Try and get things kick-started for them. And you know at the half, they discussed how they were going to get that done. This is where scripting comes into play a lot of the time.
How many plays do you script?
Most of the time in the first half, you're scripting 12 to 16. I think in the second half, you're really scripting more like 8 to 10, kind of a starter or an opener, whatever terminology they use, just something to get you off to a quick start.
They stay on the ground. Again, it's a giant. Only three there on the pickup, but that's enough to move the chains.
Second and two is prime time for a little bit of a gamble, isn't it? Open up the playbook, go play action, toss that bad boy deep. But in this situation, go ahead and give it to your back. Let him pick up a first down, keep the sticks moving.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. Him a fresh set of downs.
I like how they worked the tight end on a nice little under route there, and if you're going to give him that much space, he's not even going to catch the football. He's going to run away from you a little bit, and that's exactly what he just did there, picking up extra yardage.
This is a Jay. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 45-yard line. The loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
An interesting and intriguing decision there defensively because they kept extra DBs on the field despite seeing the multiple tight end look that came out for the offense.
I thought they were going to switch out of it. I didn't know if they felt they didn't have time or what the case was.
Well, in any event, the extra speed allowed for great penetration as they stuck that one behind the line of scrimmage.
And that play going absolutely nowhere as he's belted before he could get out of the backfield.
It's real easy to say this running game needs to be better, but the reality is they've been given little time to actually find a place to run the football. It's almost like the defense is there on the handoff.
On third and long, it's Wentz. And he's going to be intercepted a third time. Picked off by Bryce Callahan. Oh, he slipped right by him. And he will score. Touchdown, Chicago. Well, we know this defense has athleticism. Spots like that prove us right.
I love the way that you spotlighted the athleticism because you and I both know the best athletes on the field, they play on defense.
Oh, I don't know. I was a kicker. You got to remember that now.
Come on, come on.
Fine. Gold able to tack on the extra point. And the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Now Philadelphia ready to get going on offense again. They are looking to make a bit of a 180. They are sputtering right now.
And frankly, I think it's time to call your playmakers together and say, all right, guys, we're going to lean on you through this patch. We need you to get us back on track and get us going in the right direction. So you're calling plays geared to them. Not necessarily what you look at your plays, oh, this hurts the defense. I want the ball in the hands of X, Y, and Z and see if we can move forward.
So don't get too cute. Go to the playmakers. Doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play. It'll be second down. Now a play fake. Wentz. Blitz coming and down he goes. Leonard Floyd in there to bury him for a loss of 11.
Brandon, if I'm an offensive coordinator and I see an all-out rush like that, I file it away because I'm going to use their aggressiveness against them as this game goes on. I'm going to hit them with a screen soon.
Eagles coming up here on a third and long, so Wentz and company with some work to do after the sack. Shotgun now for Wentz. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
Not only was the call spot on, how about the execution of that defense right there? Zone was absolutely locked up tight. He was trying to force it in there on third down.
But if there's a time to force it, he felt like he needed to make a play, right?
Yeah, exactly right. Third down, you got to try and find something. There's nothing available there for him.
Around the NFL, third quarter at Mercedes-Benz Stadium in Atlanta. Now you saw the score at the bottom of your screen a moment ago. We got a good one going on there. And we'll keep an eye on that one as our game goes along here. So from the 36 now, first and 10. They begin the drive with Williams. Oh, he's got some breathing room. And he takes this up right near the 45-yard line. Give him 9 on the carry that time, and they're set up with a 2nd and 1.
An opportunity to get a drive started here at the end of the third quarter. What you're trying to do is break the game down a little bit. Don't let your guys see too deep into the game, into the future, and say, oh, we got to get here. No, right here, right in front of them. Melt the clock down. Get to the fourth quarter. Try and keep going.
And try to keep that lead.
Exactly.
Again, it's Williams. And he'll get it out to midfield. Looks like, yeah, they'll spot it right at midfield at the 50. They get 5 out of that one, and it moves the chains.
Third quarter, and you've got the lead. You're not ready to go into that 4-minute offense to close the game out, but a running game can really benefit your team right now.
From the 50, it's Luck. Flush to his right. Looking deep for Gabriel. And that's going to wind up incomplete. However, we do have a flag down. Let's check in with our referee. So they saw the contact before the ball arrived. Penalty flag for pass interference.
And trying to avoid pass interference is so difficult. You're trying to slow down these skilled receivers. And somehow, some way, they make plays on the football. And sometimes you're there too soon.
After the big play, a chance to finish now on first and goal. They'll try and run. This is Williams. And he'll actually lose a little bit of yardage here. Back to the 2. And welcome back. We are in the city of brotherly love, Philadelphia. It's Bears football here. They also have the lead as well as we begin quarter number 4. Back at the 2 now. Here's 2nd and goal. They come out here in the eye. He's going to get it running right. And he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Bears. A great play there. Already his 2nd touchdown here in this opening weekend. And the Bears will extend their lead. Now Gold for the extra point. Gold with the extra point, and the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. Gold now out to kick it away. This will be fielded at the 6. And a good effort on the return there. Gets him across the 30 to the 33-yard line. And out now come the Eagles. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means they're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency, move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. To throw is Wentz. Pressure, and he's taken down. A bear sack. Khalil Mack. Not dropping into coverage. He comes on the blitz and takes him down for a loss of 9. Wentz to throw on second down. And on the catch right side, this is Sanders. And they'll take him down at the 31-yard line. The reception good for 7. It's third down. Now Wentz on third down. And they dropped him for a loss, but penalty markers are on the field. Let's see about the call. Well, we looked at each other right away. We knew that flag was coming out.
And I always enjoy the conversation post, because officials always tell you, I don't want to throw the flag, but you caused the play. You did it. I had to.
A bad time for a roughing penalty, and they get the gift of a 1st and 10. From the gun, it's Wentz. And it's incomplete. Boy, he doesn't drop many like that one. 2nd down. It's been that kind of a day so far, throwing the football. It just seems like nothing going right offensively.
Yeah, it's a catch that should have been made, pure and simple. And look, everything else that goes into running a good pass route, throw it all out if you don't catch the ball.
Been that kind of game, throwing the football so far, nothing going right offensively. And he'll be brought down just shy of midfield at the 49-yard line. Give him 3 on the screen. He couldn't break free, and it's 3rd down. Again, they'll throw with Wentz. And that is incomplete.
When a ball's tipped in the air and falls incomplete, sometimes it's almost insignificant. But not in this game, because 3 interceptions have already been thrown. So when this one got tipped in the air, you just had to wonder, could this be the 4th? Instead, it falls incomplete, and the guys on offense breathe a sigh of relief.
A critical one here if they're going to have any shot at this thing. So they'll go for it on 4th down.
Run.
Now Wentz, got to have this one. And his pass is intercepted for the 4th time today. Picked off at the 40. And now nothing but green ahead of him. And they will score. A pick 6 for a Bears touchdown. And that one will pretty much erase any hopes of a 4th quarter comeback.
With emphasis, interception, return for touchdown. Door closed, locked, reinforced.
Gold able to tack on the extra point. And the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick 6. And now the kick is away. This fielded at the 2. And shedding through the tackle. And he'll take this across the 25. Couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. The Eagles offense back out onto the field. And fresh off the pick 6. They've got to forget about that quickly.
In this case now, the guy throwing the ball, he's got to be like what we talk about with defensive backs who get beat for a long touchdown. Short-term memory, right back out there doing the things that he does best, and knowing that taking care of the ball is paramount. Here's his opportunity.
It all comes back to those defensive backs for the former DB, right?
I don't know where that comes from. It just kind of emerges out of me for some reason.
It's deep in there, right? Yeah. Second and 10 now from the 27. Wentz again here on 2nd and 10. This complete left side to Aguilar. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. First catch of the new season for him, and he picks up the 1st.
If he's their best threat on offense, use your number one cover guy on defense. It doesn't matter about size.
They have had him locked up. That just his first catch of the game. Big reason why they're down. They go play action here on first down. And this is Ertz with it, right side. And he'll get it out a couple yards shy of midfield at the 48. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion. And they'll run it here. And he'll be taken down at the 44-yard line. It's an 8-yard pickup and leads to a new set of downs.
Well, partner, I know this type of running back. I mean, this size, this intensity usually gets better as the game goes on. And I can just tell you from experience, the first few quarters, oh, you're eager. You come running up there, I'm going to tackle this guy. By the fourth quarter, you're coming up and thinking about it.
And D-line wearing down fourth quarter. Yeah, that's not a guy they want to see consistently.
Well, partner, I guess sometimes it's just a matter of philosophy. Some say run until they absolutely stop you, and others say, well, when you think they're about to stop you, fool them a little bit. I guess they should have tried to fool them on that play.
Now, Wentz, I think this is going to be a free play. And that'll be incomplete. We do have a penalty flag down, however. Let's see what that's about. And now they face a second and six after the penalty. And they'll go with a ground attack here. No gain on the play there, so they're left with a third down and six. And this defense continues to give them fits. They just can't get really anything going on the ground, can they?
I love the theme that you just brought up. This defense has been tough all game long against the run. We just saw another example of it there.
Wentz. He's going to find his running back. It's complete. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. He goes for 18 there as the drive will continue. So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's first and 10. Throwing on first is Wentz. And down he goes. They bring down Wentz on the sack. Nick Kwiatkowski coming on the blitz. He gets him for a loss of 7. Time for a break. Back to finish it off on EA Sports after this. Now following the sack, they'll look to make amends on a second down and 17. Working from the gun, Wentz. It's caught by Aguilar. And he's able to get it to the edge of the red zone at the 20-yard line. They'll wind up getting 10 back as that sets him up for third down. Throwing now is Wentz. And this is going to be incomplete.
Brandon, at least there's one bright side to that incompletion.
What's that?
It wasn't an interception.
Wow. You're a nice guy. That was kind of savage. But correct. No pick, just incomplete that time. And they're indeed going to go for it here on fourth down. So trailing here in the last quarter, let's see how this plays out. As expected, they're going for it to keep the drive alive. And this is caught. Well, they get one back, picking up the late touchdown here, but still down big. Elliott now to add the extra point. Elliott good on the extra point, and the lead now down to 20. Elliott now to kick this one away.
And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. And now the Bears coming out as they get ready. They come into enemy territory, and I don't care what the matchup is in the National Football League. You're up like this late in the game on the road. This feels pretty good.
Oh, it feels fantastic. Anytime you get a road victory in the NFL, that's a big-time accomplishment. And to do it this convincingly, that just tears up the script that every home team has, which is nobody comes into our house and pushes us around. They took care of business today.
Yeah, they pushed around, and now the final stages of this one. 8 yards on the pickup, and now they'll have some options on second and short. Here's a second and two now from the 33. They run it again with Williams. And this time not as successful as he'll get back to the line of scrimmage and no more. And now the Eagles going to signal for a timeout as they get it with under a minute to go now in the football game. The Bears on third down, a perfect 4-for-4 thus far. This time they face a third and two. Nice pickup, 10 yards and a first down on the keeper.
So finally, at this stage of the game, he lets his legs carry him for a big-time first down. But I think this is all set up by his eyes throughout the game. He's been taking it all in as he's watched this thing unfold. And finally, the eyes carried the legs and took him downfield.
You're right. His longest run of the game waited until the fourth quarter, and maybe that lulled the defense to sleep a little bit. Down to a knee here. The defense still with a couple of timeouts. We'll see if they want to use them. And partner, this first week, this first game that we get to call together, so special every year, week one. You had the flyover, the big American flag out there before the game, all the hoopla, just having football back, so special.
It is an opening day, opening game. There's just nothing like it because you really build to a crescendo. But the best part for us is that crescendo lasts for a while. Opening game here, an entire season, we get into the playoffs, to the Super Bowl. I was really excited. I could barely sleep last night. I can't imagine being a player.
So for Chicago, not much to complain about here. They come in and steal a victory in a tough place to play on a Sunday night. And they will head home next week to take on the Washington Redskins. Meanwhile, for Philadelphia, they go down to defeat here in the opener. And they'll look to get back on the beam next week as they host the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. Thanks for tuning in, everybody. Alongside Charles Davis, we thank our entire crew. I'm Brandon Gauden. This is the NFL on EA Sports.
just say.